Hi there, we're here to tell you about our poster, which is titled Anything But the Phone, Communication Mode Preferences in the Autism Community. So my name is Pip Howard and I'm a lecturer at the University of Bristol.
And I'm Felicity Sedgewick, I'm also a lecturer at the University of Bristol. We chose to do this study because we know anecdotally that autistic people find different modes of communication an accessibility issue in different scenarios in their lives. And while there's been lots of research about autistic communication skills, there hasn't been very much on autistic communication preferences and what works for autistic people themselves.
So to study this, we conducted an online survey. We had 245 autistic people take part, and this survey asked people what their communication mode preferences are in a range of different scenarios. So for example, whether people preferred communicating face-to-face or via email or on the phone, when at school, in education, accessing services, or at work. And in addition to this, people were asked to give some responses on why they'd made the choices that they had, so to give us some explanations for the reasons that they have certain preferences. Now, the data from that survey indicated that people's preferences varied according to the scenario that they were responding to. So scenarios that involved speaking to people that the participants were unfamiliar with, such as when accessing services or gaining customer support, we saw a really strong preference for emails and a strong dislike of phone calls. Whereas in scenarios where people tended to know the people they were communicating with, such as friends and family, and sometimes at work and at school, we saw a preference of both written communication, such as text messages, and face-to-face communication.
And that was really backed up in the qualitative responses where people explained their choices to us. So the first theme was not the phone. And then people also talked about their preference for written communication, the differences for them in communicating with other autistic people or people who knew them well versus people who didn't, where they felt they had to mask. And also about avoiding communication overall.
So in conclusion, this study demonstrates some strong evidence that organisations and services should offer lots of different ways of communicating to improve accessibility and autonomy for the autism community. This paper is in press at the journal Autism, so if you want a copy, please just get in touch. Thanks.
Thank you.